pleasure. Thank you for having me.
So a number of weeks ago, back in early March, you came on our show. You were here in New York City. You had been exiled from Libya for 30 years, and you said you hoped to get back to Libya within a month. There you are. What does it feel like? What does it look like?
Wow, it's a fantasy land. I mean, like Alice in the Wonderland waiting for Godot. It's just unbelievable. I mean, for me, it's just a new adventure, a new life. And it has taught me to look at life in a different way, to throw what I've learned over the last 30 years as an instructor in international relations and start looking at it differently, which is really phenomenal. But it's fantastic to be here, to see how people are, to see life.
Now, you have been reconnected with family. You've been reconnected with friends whom you had not seen for decades. But you're in Benghazi, which is, of course, the capital or the seat of the opposition government. Do you have a sense that there is a government there that is in control of the opposition movement?
Quite not really, Elliot. I mean, I'll tell you, it really is a problem. They're trying very, very hard. But I don't think it has sunk in yet. I don't think it has sunk in that they're free. And that being free requires you to do certain things. I think they're still trying very hard to come to grips with that. It's funny and it's fascinating how the society itself is able to adjust. In this chaos, there are no police in the streets, but people stop at stop signs, and they stop at red lights. And so you find that very clear. You find normalcy, trying to achieve normalcy in life. But underneath that, there's a certain amount of fear. The fear of what is going to happen tomorrow. Will Gaddafi come back? Will the allies let us down? Will they help us? And so there's this constant questioning going on in their minds. And so it hasn't set in quite yet whether they're really free or not. But even during the circumstances, they're trying to do the best they can on a daily basis.
So it sounds to me as though one problem that you have diagnosed that certainly has been written about is there is a lack of certainty about who actually is in command of the military, different generals vying for power. There is also a very fundamental question. How many troops are there? How many members of the army are actually going out to fight against Gaddafi's forces? We had one report that there are only a few hundred. What is your sense? Have you seen the troops? Do you have a sense of order of magnitude?
Well, really, we have two groups. We have the general, the actual military itself, and this is under Abdel Fattah Yunus, whom I personally think is very, very capable, honest. He's a very capable man. He's head of the special forces, and he has the loyalty of many of the soldiers, very professional soldiers, and he's working very hard to train young men to actually take over, to be able to defend the city. And then we have the other group. The other group, we call the insurgents, and they had their armed, and they're fixated on removing Gaddafi. And so, in fact, they're more of a hindrance than help. But so they keep on moving forward towards Tripoli, and they're being pushed back. I'm sorry to say, but they are fodder. And I hate to say this word, but they won't listen. They won't listen to the military itself.